you're listening to this. You are the resistance.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis uccelli et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini.
But if the party remain alive a day or two, he shall not be subject to the punishment, because it is his money. If men quarrel, and one strike a woman with child, and she miscarry indeed, but live herself, he shall be answerable for so much damage as the woman's husband shall require, and as arbiter shall award. But if her death ensue thereupon, he shall render life for life. Eye for eye, tooth for tooth, hand for hand, foot for foot, burning for burning, wound for wound, stripe for stripe. If any man strike the eye of his manservant or maidservant, and leave them but one eye, he shall let them go free for the eye which he put out. Also if he strike out the tooth of his manservant or maidservant, he shall in like manner make them free. If an ox gore a man or a woman, and they die, he shall be stoned, and his flesh shall not be eaten, but the owner of the ox shall be quit. But if the ox was wont to push with his horn yesterday and the day before, and they warned his master, and he did not shut him up, and he shall kill a man or a woman, then the ox shall be stoned, and his owner also shall be put to death. And if they set a price upon him, he shall give for his life whatsoever is laid upon him. If he have gored a son, or a daughter, he shall fall under the like sentence. If he assault a bondman or a bondwoman, he shall give 30 sickles of silver to their master, and the ox shall be stoned. If a man open a pit, and dig one, and cover it not, and an ox or an ass fall into it, the owner of the pit shall pay the price of the beasts, and that which is dead shall be his own. If one man's ox gore another man's ox, and he die, they shall sell the live ox, and shall divide the price, and the carcass of that which died they shall part between them. But if he knew that his ox was wont to push yesterday and the day before, and his master did not keep him in, he shall pay ox for ox, and shall take the whole carcass. The punishment of theft, and other trespasses. The law of lending without usury, of taking pledges of relevances to superiors, and of paying tithes. If any man steal an ox or a sheep, and kill or sell it, he shall restore 5 oxen for 1 ox, and 4 sheep for 1 sheep. If a thief be found breaking open a house or undermining it, and be wounded so as to die, he that slew him shall not be guilty of blood. But if he did this when the sun is risen, he hath committed murder, and he shall die. If he have not wherewith to make restitution for the theft, he shall be sold. If that which he stole be found with him, alive, either ox, or ass, or sheep, he shall restore double. If any man herd a field or a vineyard, and put in his beast to feed upon that which is other men's, he shall restore the best of whatsoever he hath in his own field, or in his vineyard, according to the estimation of the damage. If a fire breaking out light upon thorns, and catch stacks of corn, or corn standing in the fields, he that kindled the fire shall make good the loss. If a man deliver money, or any vessel unto his friends to keep, and they be stolen away from him that received them, if the thief be found he shall restore double, if the thief be not known, the master of the house shall be brought to the gods, and shall swear that he did not lay his hand upon his neighbor's goods, to do any fraud, either in ox, or in ass, or sheep, or raiment, or anything that may bring damage. The cause of both parties shall come to the gods, and if they give judgment, he shall restore double to his neighbor. If a man deliver ass, ox, sheep, or any beast, to his neighbor's custody, and it die, or be hurt, or be taken by enemies, and no man saw it, there shall be an oath between them, that he did not put forth his hand to his neighbor's goods, and the owner shall accept of the oath, and he shall not be compelled to make restitution. But if it were taken away by stealth, he shall make the loss good to the owner. If it were eaten by a beast, let him bring to him that which was slain, and he shall not make restitution. If a man borrow of his neighbor any of these things, and it be hurt or die, the owner not being present, he shall be obliged to make restitution. But if the owner be present, he shall not make restitution, especially if it were hired and came for the hire of his work. If a man seduce a virgin not yet espoused, and lie with her, he shall endow her, and have her to wife. If the maid's father will not give her to him, he shall give money according to the dowry, which virgins are wont to receive. Wizards thou shalt not suffer to live. Whosoever copulateth with a beast shall be put to death. He that sacrificeth to gods, shall be put to death, save only to the Lord. Thou shalt not molest a stranger, nor afflict him. For yourselves also were strangers in the land of Egypt. You shall not hurt a widow or an orphan. If you hurt them, they will cry out to me, and I will hear their cry, and my rage shall be enkindled, and I will strike you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless. If thou lend money to any of my people that is poor, that dwelleth with thee, thou shalt not be hard upon them as an extortioner, nor oppress them with usuries. If thou take of thy neighbor a garment in pledge, thou shalt give it him again before sunset. For that same is the only thing wherewith he is covered, the clothing of his body, neither hath he any other to sleep in. If he cry to me, I will hear him, because I am compassionate. Thou shalt not speak ill of the gods, and the prince of thy people thou shalt not curse. Thou shalt not delay to pay thy tithes and thy first fruits, thou shalt give the firstborn of thy sons to me. Thou shalt do the same with the firstborn of thy oxen also and sheep, 7 days let it be with its dam, the 8th day thou shalt give it to me. You shall be holy men to me, the flesh that beasts have tasted of before, you shall not eat, but shall see laws for judges, the rest of the 7th year, and day, 3 principal feasts to be solemnized every year, the promise of an angel, to conduct and protect them, idols are to be destroyed. Thou shalt not receive the voice of a lie, neither shalt thou join thy hands to bear false witness for a wicked person. Thou shalt not follow the multitude to do evil, neither shalt thou yield in judgment, to the opinion of the most part, to stray from the truth. Neither shalt thou favor a poor man in judgment. If thou meet thy enemy's ox or ass going astray, bring it back to him. If thou see the ass of him that hateth thee lie underneath his burden, thou shalt not pass by, but shalt lift him up with him. Thou shalt not go aside in the poor man's judgment. Thou shalt fly lying. The innocent and just person thou shalt not put to death, because I abhor the wicked. Neither shalt thou take bribes, which even blind the wise, and pervert the words of the just. Thou shalt not molest a stranger, for you know the hearts of strangers, for you also were strangers in the land of Egypt. 6 years thou shalt sow thy ground, and shalt gather the corn thereof. But the 7th year thou shalt let it alone, and suffer it to rest, that the poor of thy people may eat, and whatsoever shall be left, let the beasts of the field eat it, so shalt thou do with thy vineyard and thy oliveyard. 6 days thou shalt work, the 7th day thou shalt cease, that thy ox and thy ass may rest, and the son of thy handmaid and the stranger may be refreshed. Keep all things that I have said to you. And by the name of strange gods you shall not swear, neither shall it be heard out of your mouth. 3 times every year you shall celebrate feasts to me. Thou shalt keep the feast of unleavened bread. 7 days shalt thou eat unleavened bread, as I commanded thee, in the time of the month of new corn, when thou didst come forth out of Egypt, thou shalt not appear empty before me. And the feast of the harvest of the first fruits of thy work, whatsoever thou hast sown in the field. The feast also in the end of the year, when thou hast gathered in all thy corn out of the field. 3 times a year shall all thy males appear before the Lord thy God. Thou shalt not sacrifice the blood of my victim upon leaven, neither shall the fat of my solemnity remain until the morning. Thou shalt carry the first fruits of the corn of thy ground to the house of the Lord thy God. Thou shalt not boil a kid in the milk of his dam. Behold, I will send my angel, who shall go before thee, and keep thee in thy journey, and bring thee into the place that I have prepared. Take notice of him, and hear his voice, and do not think him one to be contemned, for he will not forgive when thou hast sinned, and my name is in him. But if thou wilt hear his voice, and do all that I speak, I will be an enemy to thy enemies, and will afflict them that afflict thee. And my angel shall go before thee, and shall bring thee in unto the Amorite, and the Hethite, and the Pherezite, and the Chananite, and the Hevite, and the Jebusite, whom I will destroy. Thou shalt not adore their gods, nor serve them. Thou shalt not do their works, but shalt destroy them, and break their statues. And you shall serve the Lord your God, that I may bless your bread and your waters, and may take away sickness from the midst of thee. There shall not be one fruitless nor barren in thy land, I will fill the number of thy days. I will send my fear before thee, and will destroy all the people to whom thou shalt come, and will turn the backs of all thy enemies before thee. Sending out hornets before, that shall drive away the Hevite, and the Chananite, and the Hethite, before thou come in. I will not cast them out from thy face in 1 year, lest the land be brought into a wilderness, and the beasts multiply against thee. By little and little I will drive them out from before thee, till thou be increased, and dost possess the land. And I will set thy bounds from the Red Sea to the Sea of the Palestines, and from the desert to the river, I will deliver the inhabitants of the land into your hands, and will drive them out from before you. Thou shalt not enter into league with them, nor with their gods. Let them not dwell in thy land, lest perhaps I make thee sin against me, if thou serve their God, which undoubtedly will be a scandal to thee. Ask it to the dogs. Moses writeth his law, and after offering sacrifices, sprinkleth the blood of the testament upon the people, then goeth up the mountain which God covereth with a fiery cloud. And he said to Moses, Come up to the Lord, thou, and Aaron, Nadab, and Abihu, and 70 of the ancients of Israel, and you shall adore afar off. And Moses alone shall come up to the Lord, but they shall not come nigh, neither shall the people come up with him. So Moses came and told the people all the words of the Lord, and all the judgments, and all the people answered with one voice, We will do all the words of the Lord, which he hath spoken. And Moses wrote all the words of the Lord, and rising in the morning he built an altar at the foot of the mount, and 12 titles according to the 12 tribes of Israel. And he sent young men of the children of Israel, and they offered holocausts, and sacrificed pacific victims of calves to the Lord. Titles, that is, pillars. Holocausts, whole burnt offerings, in which the whole sacrifice was consumed with fire upon the altar. Then Moses took half of the blood, and put it into bowls, and the rest he poured upon the altar. And taking the book of the covenant, he read it in the hearing of the people, and they said, All things that the Lord hath spoken we will do, we will be obedient. And he took the blood and sprinkled it upon the people, and he said, This is the blood of the covenant which the Lord hath made with you concerning all these words. Then Moses and Aaron, Nadab and Abihu, and 70 of the ancients of Israel went up, and they saw the God of Israel, and under his feet as it were a work of sapphire stone, and as the heaven, when clear. Neither did he lay his hand upon those of the children of Israel, that retired afar off, and they saw God, and they did eat and drink. And the Lord said to Moses, Come up to me into the mount, and be there, and I will give thee tables of stone, and the law, and the commandments which I have written, that thou mayst teach them. Moses rose up, and his minister Joshua, and Moses going up into the mount of God, said to the ancients, Wait ye here till we return to you. You have Aaron and Hur with you, if any question shall arise, you shall refer it to them. And when Moses was gone up, a cloud covered the mount. And the glory of the Lord dwelt upon Sinai, covering it with a cloud 6 days, and the 7th day he called him out of the midst of the cloud. And the sight of the glory of the Lord was like a burning fire upon the top of the mount, in the eyes of the children of Israel. And Moses, entering into the midst of the cloud, went up into the mountain, and he was there 40 days, and 40 nights. Offerings prescribed for making the tabernacle, the ark, the candlestick, etc. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the children of Israel, that they bring first fruits to me, of every man that offereth of his own accord, you shall take them. And these are the things you must take, gold, and silver, and brass, violet and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine linen, and goat's hair, and ram skins dyed red, and violet skins, and setim wood. First fruits, offerings of some of the best and choicest of their goods. Setim wood, the wood of a tree that grows in the wilderness, which is said to be incorruptible. Oil to make lights, spices for ointment, and for sweet-smelling incense, onyx stones, and precious stones to adorn the ephod and the rational. And they shall make me a sanctuary, and I will dwell in the midst of them, according to all the likeness of the tabernacle which I will show thee, and of all the vessels for the service thereof, and thus you shall make it, frame an ark of setim wood, the length whereof shall be of 2 cubits and a half, the breadth, 1 cubit and a half, the height, likewise, 1 cubit and a half. The ephod and the rational. The ephod was the high priest's upper vestment, and the rational his breastplate, in which were 12 gems, etc. And thou shalt overlay it with the purest gold within and without, and over it thou shalt make a golden crown round about, and four golden rings, which thou shalt put at the four corners of the ark. Let two rings be on the one side, and two on the other. Thou shalt make bars also of sedum wood, and shalt overlay them with gold. And thou shalt put them in through the rings that are in the sides of the ark, that it may be carried on them. And they shall be always in the rings, neither shall they at any time be drawn out of them. And thou shalt put in the ark the testimony which I will give thee. Thou shalt make also a propitiatory of the purest gold, the length thereof shall be 2 cubits and a half, and the breadth 1 cubit and a half. Thou shalt make also 2 cherubims of beaten gold, on the 2 sides of the oracle. Let one cherub be on the one side, and the other on the other. Let them cover both sides of the propitiatory, spreading their wings, and covering the oracle, and let them look one towards the other, their faces being turned towards the propitiatory wherewith the ark is to be covered. A propitiatory, a covering for the ark, called a propitiatory, or mercy seat, because the Lord, who was supposed to sit there upon the wings of the cherubims, with the ark for his footstool, from thence showed mercy. It is also called the oracle, ver. And, because from thence God gave his orders and his answers. In which thou shalt put the testimony that I will give thee. Thence will I give orders, and will speak to thee over the propitiatory, and from the midst of the 2 cherubims, which shall be upon the ark of the testimony, all things which I will command the children of Israel by thee. Thou shalt make a table also of sedum wood, of 2 cubits in length, and 1 cubit in breadth, and 1 cubit and a half in height. And thou shalt overlay it with the purest gold, and thou shalt make to it a golden ledge round about. And to the ledge itself a polished crown, 4 inches high, and over the same another little golden crown, a table, on which were to be placed the 12 loaves of proposition, or, as they are called in the Hebrew, the face bread, because they were always to stand before the face of the Lord in his temple, as a figure of the Eucharistic sacrifice and sacrament, in the Church of Christ. Thou shalt prepare also 4 golden rings, and shalt put them in the 4 corners of the same table over each foot. Under the crown shall the golden rings be, that the bars may be put through them, and the table may be carried. The bars also themselves thou shalt make of sedum wood, and shalt overlay them with gold to bear up the table. Thou shalt prepare also dishes, and bowls, censers, and cups, wherein the libations are to be offered of the purest gold. And thou shalt set upon the table loaves of proposition in my sight always. Libations, that is, drink offerings. Thou shalt make also a candlestick of beaten work of the finest gold, the shaft thereof, and the branches, the cups, and the bowls, and the lilies going forth from it. 6 branches shall come out of the sides, 3 out of the one side, and 3 out of the other. 3 cups as it were nuts to every branch, and a bowl withal, and a lily, and 3 cups, likewise of the fashion of nuts in the other branch, and a bowl withal, and a lily. Such shall be the work of the 6 branches, that are to come out from the shaft, and in the candlestick itself shall be 4 cups in the manner of a nut, and at every one, bowls and lilies. Bowls under 2 branches in 3 places, which together make 6 coming forth out of 1 shaft. A candlestick, this candlestick, with its 7 lamps, which was always to give light in the house of God, was a figure of the light of the Holy Ghost, and his 7-fold grace, in the sanctuary of the Church of Christ. And both the bowls and the branches shall be of the same beaten work of the purest gold. Thou shalt make also 7 lamps, and shalt set them upon the candlestick, to give light over against. The snuffers also and where the snuffings shall be put out, shall be made of the purest gold. The whole weight of the candlestick with all the furniture thereof shall be 1 talent of the purest gold. Look and make it according to the pattern, that was shown thee in the mount. The form of the tabernacle with its appurtenances. And thou shalt make the tabernacle in this manner, thou shalt make 10 curtains of fine twisted linen, and violet and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, diversified with embroidery. The length of 1 curtain shall be 28 cubits, the breadth shall be 4 cubits. All the curtains shall be of 1 measure. 5 curtains shall be joined one to another, and the other 5 shall be coupled together in like manner. Thou shalt make loops of violet in the sides and tops of the curtains, that they may be joined one to another. Every curtain shall have 50 loops on both sides, so set on, that one loop may be against another loop, and one may be fitted to the other. Thou shalt make also 50 rings of gold wherewith the veils of the curtains are to be joined, that it may be made one tabernacle. Thou shalt make also 11 curtains of goat's hair, to cover the top of the tabernacle. The length of one hair curtain shall be 30 cubits, and the breadth 4, the measure of all the curtains shall be equal. 5 of which thou shalt couple by themselves, and the 6 others thou shalt couple one to another, so as to double the 6th curtain in the front of the roof. Thou shalt make also 50 loops in the edge of one curtain, that it may be joined with the other, and 50 loops in the edge of the other curtain, that it may be coupled with its fellow. Thou shalt make also 50 buckles of brass, wherewith the loops may be joined, that of all there may be made one covering. And that which shall remain of the curtains, that are prepared for the roof, to wit, one curtain that is over and above, with the half thereof thou shalt cover the back parts of the tabernacle. And there shall hang down a cubit on the one side, and another on the other side, which is over and above in the length of the curtains, fencing both sides of the tabernacle. Thou shalt make also another cover to the roof, of ram skins dyed red, and over that again another cover of violet colored skins. Thou shalt make also the boards of the tabernacle standing upright of setim wood. Let every one of them be 10 cubits in length, and in breadth 1 cubit and a half. In the sides of the board shall be made 2 mortises, whereby one board may be joined to another board, and after this manner shall all the boards be prepared. Of which 20 shall be in the south side southward. For which thou shalt cast 40 sockets of silver, that under every board may be put 2 sockets at the 2 corners. In the second side also the tabernacle that looketh to the north, there shall be 20 boards. Having 40 sockets of silver, 2 sockets shall be put under each board. But on the west side of the tabernacle thou shalt make 6 boards. And again other 2 which shall be erected in the corners at the back of the tabernacle. And they shall be joined together from beneath unto the top, and one joint shall hold them all. The like joining shall be observed for the 2 boards also that are to be put in the corners. And they shall be in all 8 boards, and their silver sockets 16, reckoning 2 sockets for each board. Thou shalt make also 5 bars of setim wood, to hold together the boards on one side of the tabernacle. And 5 others on the other side, and as many at the west side, and they shall be put along by the midst of the boards from one end to the other. The boards also themselves thou shalt overlay with gold, and shall cast rings of gold to be set upon them, for places for the bars to hold together board work, which bars thou shalt cover with plates of gold. And thou shalt rear up the tabernacle according to the pattern that was shown thee in the mount. Thou shalt make also a veil of violet and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine twisted linen, wrought with embroidered work, and goodly variety, and thou shalt hang it up before 4 pillars of setim wood, which themselves also shall be overlaid with gold, and shall have heads of gold, but sockets of silver. And the veil shall be hanged on with rings, and within it thou shalt put the ark of the testimony, and the sanctuary, and the holy of holies shall be divided with it. And thou shalt set the propitiatory upon the ark of the testimony in the holy of holies. And the table without the veil, and over against the table the candlestick in the south side of the tabernacle, for the table shall stand in the north side. The sanctuary, that part of the tabernacle, which was without the veil, into which the priests daily entered, is here called the sanctuary, or holy place, that part which was within the veil, into which no one but the high priest ever went, and he but once a year, is called the Holy of Holies, literally, the sanctuary of the sanctuaries, as being the most holy of all holy places. Thou shalt make also a hanging in the entrance of the tabernacle of violet and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine twisted linen with embroidered work. And thou shalt overlay with gold 5 pillars of setim wood, before which the hanging shall be drawn, their heads shall be of gold, and the sockets of brass. The altar, and the court of the tabernacle with its hangings and pillars. Provision of oil for lamps. Thou shalt make also an altar of setim wood, which shall be 5 cubits long and as many broad, that is, 4 square, and 3 cubits high. And there shall be horns at the 4 corners of the same, and thou shalt cover it with brass. And thou shalt make for the uses thereof pans to receive the ashes, and tongs and flesh hooks, and firepans, all its vessels thou shalt make of brass. And a grate of brass in manner of a net, at the four corners of which shall be four rings of brass, which thou shalt put under the hearth of the altar, and the grate shall be even to the midst of the altar. Thou shalt make also two bars for the altar of sedum wood, which thou shalt cover with plates of brass, and thou shalt draw them through rings, and they shall be on both sides of the altar to carry it. Thou shalt not make it solid, but empty and hollow in the inside, as it was shown thee in the mount. Thou shalt make also the court of the tabernacle, in the south side whereof southward there shall be hangings of fine twisted linen of 100 cubits long for one side, and 20 pillars with as many sockets of brass, the heads of which with their engraving of silver. In like manner also on the north side there shall be hangings of 100 cubits long, 20 pillars, and as many sockets of brass, and their heads with their engraving of silver. But in the breadth of the court, that looketh to the west, there shall be hangings of 50 cubits, and 10 pillars, and as many sockets. In that breadth also of the court, which looketh to the east, there shall be 50 cubits. In which there shall be for one side hangings of 15 cubits, and 3 pillars and as many sockets. And in the other side there shall be hangings of 15 cubits, with 3 pillars and as many sockets. And in the entrance of the court there shall be made a hanging of 20 cubits of violet and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine twisted linen, with embroidered work, it shall have 4 pillars with as many sockets. All the pillars of the court round about shall be garnished with plates of silver, silver heads and sockets of brass. In length the court shall take up 100 cubits, in breadth 50, the height shall be of 5 cubits, and it shall be made of fine twisted linen, and shall have sockets of brass. All the vessels of the tabernacle for all uses and ceremonies, and the pins both of it, and of the court, thou shalt make of brass. Command the children of Israel that they bring thee the purest oil of the olives, and beaten with a pestle, that a lamp may burn always. In the tabernacle of the testimony without the veil that hangs before the testimony. And Aaron and his sons shall order it, that it may give light before the Lord until the morning. It shall be a perpetual observance throughout their successions among the children of Israel. The holy vestments for Aaron and his sons. Take unto thee also Aaron thy brother with his sons, from among the children of Israel, that they may minister to me in the priestess office, Aaron, Nadab, Abihu, Eleazar, and Thamar. And thou shalt make a holy vesture for Aaron thy brother for glory and for beauty. And thou shalt speak to all the wise of heart, whom I have filled with the spirit of wisdom, that they may make Aaron's vestments, in which he being consecrated may minister to me. And these shall be the vestments that they shall make, a rational and an ephod, a tunic and a strait linen garment, a mitre and a girdle. They shall make the holy vestments for thy brother Aaron and his sons, that they may do the office of priesthood unto me. And they shall take gold, and violet, and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine linen. And they shall make the ephod of gold, and violet, and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine twisted linen, embroidered with divers colors. It shall have the two edges joined in the top on both sides, that they may be closed together. The very workmanship also and all the variety of the work shall be of gold, and violet, and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine twisted linen. And thou shalt take 2 onyx stones, and shalt grave on them the names of the children of Israel, 6 names on one stone, and the other 6 on the other, according to the order of their birth. With the work of an engraver and the graving of a jeweler, thou shalt engrave them with the names of the children of Israel, set in gold and compassed about, and thou shalt put them in both sides of the ephod, a memorial for the children of Israel. And Aaron shall bear their names before the Lord upon both shoulders, for a remembrance. Thou shalt make also hooks of gold, and 2 little chains of the purest gold linked one to another, which thou shalt put into the hooks. And thou shalt make the rational of judgment with embroidered work of divers colors, according to the workmanship of the ephod, of gold, violet, and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine twisted linen. The rational of judgment, this part of the priest's attire, which he wore at his breast, was called the rational of judgment, partly because it admonished both priest and people of their duty to God, by carrying the names of all their tribes in his presence, and by the rumen the thummim, that is, doctrine and truth, which were written upon it, and partly because it gave divine answers and oracles, as if it were rational and endowed with judgment. It shall be four square and doubled, it shall be the measure of a span both in length and in breadth. And thou shalt set in it four rows of stones, in the first row shall be a sardius stone, and a topaz, and an emerald, in the second a carbuncle, a sapphire and a jasper. In the third a ligurius, an agate, and an amethyst, in the fourth a chrysolite, an onyx, and a beryl. They shall be set in gold by their rows. And they shall have the names of the children of Israel, with 12 names shall they be engraved, each stone with the name of one according to the 12 tribes. And thou shalt make on the rational chains linked one to another of the purest gold, and two rings of gold, which thou shalt put in the two ends at the top of the rational. And the golden chains thou shalt join to the rings, that are in the ends thereof, and the ends of the chains themselves thou shalt join together with two hooks on both sides of the ephod, which is towards the rational. Thou shalt make also two rings of gold which thou shalt put in the top parts of the rational, in the borders that are over against the ephod, and look towards the back parts thereof. Moreover also other two rings of gold, which are to be set on each side of the ephod beneath, that looketh towards the nether joining, that the rational may be fitted with the ephod, and may be fastened by the rings thereof unto the rings of the ephod with a violet fillet, that the joining artificially wrought may continue, and the rational and the ephod may not be loosed one from the other. And Aaron shall bear the names of the children of Israel and the rational of judgment upon his breast, when he shall enter into the sanctuary, a memorial before the Lord forever. And thou shalt put in the rational of judgment doctrine and truth, which shall be on Aaron's breast, when he shall go in before the Lord, and he shall bear the judgment of the children of Israel on his breast, in the sight of the Lord always. Doctrine and truth, Hebrew, rumen thummim, illuminations and perfections. These words, written on the rational, seem to signify the light of doctrine and the integrity of life, with which the priests of God ought to approach him. And thou shalt make the tunic of the ephod all of violet, in the midst whereof above shall be a hole for the head, and a border round about it woven, as is wont to be made in the outmost parts of garments, that it may not easily be broken. And beneath at the feet of the same tunic round about, thou shalt make as it were pomegranates, of violet, and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, with little bells set between, so that there shall be a golden bell and a pomegranate, and again another golden bell and a pomegranate. And Aaron shall be vested with it in the office of his ministry, that the sound may be heard, when he goeth in and cometh out of the sanctuary, in the sight of the Lord, and that he may not die. Thou shalt make also a plate of the purest gold, wherein thou shalt grave with engraver's work, holy to the Lord. And thou shalt tie it with a violet fillet, and it shall be upon the mitre, hanging over the forehead of the high priest. And Aaron shall bear the iniquities of those things, which the children of Israel have offered and sanctified, in all their gifts and offerings. And the plate shall be always on his forehead, that the Lord may be well pleased with them. And thou shalt gird the tunic with fine linen, and thou shalt make a fine linen mitre, and a girdle of embroidered work. Moreover for the sons of Aaron thou shalt prepare linen tunics, and girdles and mitres for glory and beauty. And with all these things thou shalt vest Aaron thy brother, and his sons with him. And thou shalt consecrate the hands of them all, and shalt sanctify them, that they may do the office of priesthood unto me. Thou shalt make also linen breeches, to cover the flesh of their nakedness from the reins to the thighs, and Aaron and his sons shall use them when they shall go into the tabernacle of the testimony, or when they approach the altar to minister in the sanctuary, lest being guilty of iniquity they die. It shall be a law forever to Aaron, and to his seed after him. The manner of consecrating Aaron and other priests, the institution of the daily sacrifice of two lambs, one in the morning, the other at evening. And thou shalt also do this, that they may be consecrated to me in priesthood. Take a calf from the herd, and two rams without blemish, and unleavened bread, and a cake without leaven, tempered with oil, wafers also unleavened anointed with oil. Thou shalt make them all of wheaten flour. And thou shalt put them in a basket and offer them, and the calf and the two rams. And thou shalt bring Aaron and his sons to the door of the tabernacle of the testimony. And when thou hast washed the father and his sons with water, thou shalt clothe Aaron with his vestments, that is, with the linen garment and the tunic, and the ephod and the rational, which thou shalt gird with the girdle. And thou shalt put the mitre upon his head, and the holy plate upon the mitre, and thou shalt pour the oil of unction upon his head, and by this rite shall he be consecrated. Thou shalt bring his sons also and shalt put on them the linen tunics, and gird them with the girdle, to wit, Aaron and his children, and thou shalt put mitres upon them, and they shall be priests to me by a perpetual ordinance. After thou shalt have consecrated their hands, thou shalt present also the calf before the tabernacle of the testimony. And Aaron and his sons shall lay their hands upon his head. And thou shalt kill him in the sight of the Lord, beside the door of the tabernacle of the testimony. And taking some of the blood of the calf, thou shalt put it upon the horns of the altar with thy finger, and the rest of the blood thou shalt pour at the bottom thereof. Thou shalt take also all the fat that covereth the entrails, and the caul of the liver, and the two kidneys, and the fat that is upon them, and shalt offer a burnt offering upon the altar, but the flesh of the calf and the hide and the dung, thou shalt burn abroad, without the camp, because it is for sin. Thou shalt take also one ram upon the head whereof Aaron and his sons shall lay their hands. And when thou hast killed him, thou shalt take of the blood thereof, and pour round about the altar, and thou shalt cut the ram in pieces, and having washed his entrails and feet, thou shalt put them upon the flesh that is cut in pieces, and upon his head. And thou shalt offer the whole ram for a burnt offering upon the altar, it is an oblation to the Lord, a most sweet savour of the victim of the Lord. Thou shalt take also the other ram, upon whose head Aaron and his sons shall lay their hands. And when thou hast sacrificed him, thou shalt take of his blood, and put upon the tip of the right ear of Aaron and of his sons, and upon the thumbs and great toes of their right hand and foot, and thou shalt pour the blood upon the altar round about. And when thou hast taken of the blood, that is upon the altar, and of the oil of unction, thou shalt sprinkle Aaron and his vesture, his sons and their vestments. And after they and their vestments are consecrated, thou shalt take the fat of the ram, and the rump, and the fat that covereth the lungs, and the caul of the liver, and the two kidneys, and the fat that is upon them, and the right shoulder, because it is the ram of consecration. And one roll of bread, a cake tempered with oil, a wafer out of the basket of unleavened bread, which is set in the sight of the Lord. And thou shalt put all upon the hands of Aaron and of his sons, and shalt sanctify them elevating before the Lord. And thou shalt take all from their hands, and shalt burn them upon the altar for a holocaust, a most sweet savour in the sight of the Lord, because it is his oblation. Thou shalt take also the breast of the ram, wherewith Aaron was consecrated, and elevating it thou shalt sanctify it before the Lord, and it shall fall to thy share. And thou shalt sanctify both the consecrated breast, and the shoulder that thou didst separate of the ram, wherewith Aaron was consecrated and his sons, and they shall fall to Aaron's share and his sons by a perpetual right from the children of Israel, because they are the choicest and the beginnings of their peace victims which they offer to the Lord. And the holy vesture, which Aaron shall use, his sons shall have after him, that they may be anointed, and their hands consecrated to it. He of his sons that shall be appointed high priest in his stead, and that shall enter into the tabernacle of the testimony to minister in the sanctuary, shall wear it 7 days. And thou shalt take the ram of the consecration, and shalt boil the flesh thereof in the holy place, and Aaron and his sons shall eat it. The loaves also, that are in the basket, they shall eat in the entry of the tabernacle of the testimony, that it may be an atoning sacrifice, and the hands of the offerers may be sanctified. A stranger shall not eat of them, because they are holy. And if there remain of the consecrated flesh, or of the bread till the morning, thou shalt burn the remainder with fire, they shall not be eaten, because they are sanctified. All that I have commanded thee, thou shalt do unto Aaron and his sons. 7 days shalt thou consecrate their hands. And thou shalt offer a calf for sin every day for expiation. And thou shalt cleanse the altar when thou hast offered the victim of expiation, and shalt anoint it to sanctify it. 7 days shalt thou expiate the altar and sanctify it, and it shall be most holy. Every one that shall touch it shall be holy. This is what thou shalt sacrifice upon the altar, two lambs of a year old every day continually. One lamb in the morning and another in the evening. With one lamb a tenth part of flour tempered with beet oil, of the fourth part of a hin, and wine for libation of the same measure. And the other lamb thou shalt offer in the evening, according to the rite of the morning oblation, and according to what we have said, for a savour of sweetness. It is a sacrifice to the Lord, by perpetual oblation unto your generations, at the door of the tabernacle of the testimony before the Lord, where I will appoint to speak unto thee. And there will I command the children of Israel, and the altar shall be sanctified by my glory. I will sanctify also the tabernacle of the testimony with the altar, and Aaron with his sons, to do the office of priesthood unto me. And I will dwell in the midst of the children of Israel, and will be their God. And they shall know that I am the Lord their God, who have brought them out of the land of Egypt, that I might abide among them, I the Lord their God. The altar of incense, money to be gathered for the use of the tabernacle, the brazen laver, the holy oil of unction, and the composition of the perfume. Thou shalt make also an altar to burn incense, of setim wood. It shall be a cubit in length, and another in breadth, that is, four square, and two in height. Horns shall go out of the same. And thou shalt overlay it with the purest gold, as well as the grate thereof, as the walls round about and the horns. And thou shalt make to it a crown of gold round about, and two golden rings under the crown on either side, that the bars may be put into them, and the altar be carried. And thou shalt make the bars also of setim wood, and shalt overlay them with gold. An altar to burn incense. This burning of incense was an emblem of prayer, ascending to God from an inflamed heart. Cp's, Apoc, and. And thou shalt set the altar over against the veil, that hangeth before the ark of the testimony before the propitiatory wherewith the testimony is covered, where I will speak to thee. And Aaron shall burn sweet-smelling incense upon it in the morning. When he shall dress the lamps, he shall burn it, and when he shall place them in the evening, he shall burn an everlasting incense before the Lord throughout your generations. You shall not offer upon it incense of another composition nor oblation, and victim, neither shall you offer libations. And Aaron shall pray upon the horns thereof once a year, with the blood of that which was offered for sin, and shall make atonement upon it in your generations. It shall be most holy to the Lord. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, When thou shalt take the sum of the children of Israel according to their number, every one of them shall give a price for their souls to the Lord. And there shall be no scourge among them, when they shall be reckoned. And this shall every one give that passeth at the naming, half a sickle according to the standard of the temple. A sickle hath 20 obols. Half a sickle shall be offered to the Lord. He that is counted in the number from 20 years and upwards, shall give the price. The rich man shall not add to half a sickle, and the poor man shall diminish nothing. Half a sickle or shekel of silver, which was also called a stater, according to the standard or weight of the sanctuary, which was the most just and exact, was half an ounce of silver, that is, about half a crown of English money. The obol, or gira, was about 3 halfpence. And the money received which was contributed by the children of Israel, thou shalt deliver unto the uses of the tabernacle of the testimony, that it may be a memorial of them before the Lord, and he may be merciful to their souls. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Thou shalt make also a brazen laver with its foot, to wash in, and thou shalt set it between the tabernacle of the testimony and the altar. And water being put into it, Aaron and his sons shall wash their hands and feet in it, when they are going into the tabernacle of the testimony, and when they are to come to the altar, to offer on it incense to the Lord. Lest perhaps they die. It shall be an everlasting law to him, and to his seed by successions. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Take spices, of principal and chosen myrrh 500 sickles, and of cinnamon half so much, that is, 250 sickles, of calamus in like manner 250. And of cassia 500 sickles by the weight of the sanctuary, of oil of olives the measure hin, and thou shalt make the holy oil of unction, an ointment compounded after the art of the perfumer. And therewith thou shalt anoint the tabernacle of the testimony, and the ark of the testament, and the table with the vessels thereof, the candlestick and furniture thereof, the altars of incense, and of holocaust, and all the furniture that belongeth to the service of them. And thou shalt sanctify all, and they shall be most holy, he that shall touch them shall be sanctified. Thou shalt anoint Aaron and his sons, and shalt sanctify them, that they may do the office of priesthood unto me. And thou shalt say to the children of Israel, this oil of unction shall be holy unto me throughout your generations. The flesh of man shall not be anointed therewith, and you shall make none other of the same composition, because it is sanctified, and shall be holy unto you. What man soever shall compound such, and shall give thereof to a stranger, he shall be cut off from his people. And the Lord said to Moses, take unto thee spices, stacte, and onycha, galbanum of sweet savour, and the clearest frankincense, all shall be of equal weight. And thou shalt make incense compounded by the work of the perfumer, well tempered together, and pure, and most worthy of sanctification. And when thou hast beaten all into very small powder, thou shalt set of it before the tabernacle of the testimony, in the place where I will appear to thee. Most holy shall this incense be to you. You shall not make such a composition for your own uses, because it is holy to the Lord. What man soever shall make the like, to enjoy the smell thereof, he shall perish out of his people. Basleel and Oholiab are appointed by the Lord to make the tabernacle, and the things belonging thereto. The observation of the Sabbath day is again commanded. And the Lord delivereth to Moses two tables written with the finger of God. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, behold, I have called by name Basleel the son of Uri the son of Hur of the tribe of Judah, and I have filled him with the Spirit of God, with wisdom and understanding, and knowledge in all manner of work. To devise whatsoever may be artificially made of gold, and silver, and brass, of marble, and precious stones, and variety of wood. And I have given him for his companion Oholiab the son of Achizamak of the tribe of Dan. And I have put wisdom in the heart of every skillful man, that they may make all things which I have commanded thee, the tabernacle of the covenant, and the ark of the testimony, and the propitiatory that is over it, and all the vessels of the tabernacle, and the table and the vessels thereof, the most pure candlestick with the vessels thereof, and the altars of incense, and of holocaust, and all their vessels, the laver with its foot, the holy vestments in the ministry for Aaron the priest, and for his sons, that they may execute their office about the sacred things. The oil of unction, and the incense of spices in the sanctuary, all things which I have commanded thee, shall they make. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to the children of Israel, and thou shalt say to them, see that thou keep my Sabbath, because it is a sign between me and you in your generations, that you may know that I am the Lord, who sanctify you. Keep you my Sabbath, for it is holy unto you, he that shall profane it, shall be put to death, he that shall do my work in it, his soul shall perish out of the midst of his people. 6 days shall you do work, in the seventh day is the Sabbath, the rest holy to the Lord. Every one that shall do any work on this day, shall die. Let the children of Israel keep the Sabbath, and celebrate it in their generations. It is an everlasting covenant between me and the children of Israel, and a perpetual sign. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, and in the seventh he ceased from work. And the Lord, when he had ended these words on Mount Sinai, gave to Moses two stone tables of testimony, written with the finger of God. The people fall into idolatry. Moses prayeth for them. He breaketh the tables, destroyeth the idol, blameth Aaron, and causeth many of the idolaters to be slain. And the people, seeing that Moses delayed to come down from the mount, gathering together against Aaron, said, arise, make us gods, that may go before us, for as to this Moses, the man that brought us out of the land of Egypt, we know not what has befallen him. And Aaron said to them, take the golden earrings from the ears of your wives, and your sons and daughters, and bring them to me. And the people did what he had commanded, bringing the earrings to Aaron. And when he had received them, he fashioned them by founder's work, and made of them a molten calf. And they said, these are thy gods, O Israel, that have brought thee out of the land of Egypt. And when Aaron saw this, he built an altar before it, and made proclamation by a crieth voice, saying, tomorrow is the solemnity of the Lord. And rising in the morning, they offered holocausts, and peace victims, and the people sat down to eat, and drink, and they rose up to play. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Go, get thee down, thy people, which thou hast brought out of the land of Egypt, hath sinned. They have quickly strayed from the way which thou didst show them, and they have made to themselves a molten calf, and have adored it, and sacrificing victims to it, have said, These are thy gods, O Israel, that have brought thee out of the land of Egypt. And again the Lord said to Moses, See that this people is stiff-necked, let me alone, that my wrath may be kindled against them, and that I may destroy them, and I will make of thee a great nation. But Moses besought the Lord his God, saying, Why, O Lord, is thy indignation kindled against thy people, whom thou hast brought out of the land of Egypt, with great power, and with a mighty hand? Let not the Egyptians say, I beseech thee, he craftily brought them out, that he might kill them in the mountains, and destroy them from the earth. Let thy anger cease, and be appeased upon the wickedness of thy people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, thy servants, to whom thou swarest by thy own self, saying, I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven, and this whole land that I have spoken of, I will give to you seed, and you shall possess it forever. And the Lord was appeased from doing the evil which he had spoken against his people. And Moses returned from the mount, carrying the two tables of the testimony in his hand, written on both sides. And made by the work of God, the writing also of God was graven in the tables. And Joshua, hearing the noise of the people shouting, said to Moses, The noise of battle is heard in the camp. But he answered, It is not the cry of men encouraging to fight, nor the shout of men compelling to flee, but I hear the voice of singers. And when he came nigh to the camp, he saw the calf, and the dances, and being very angry, he threw the tables out of his hand, and broke them at the foot of the mount, and laying hold of the calf which they had made, he burned it, and beat it to powder, which he strowed into water, and gave thereof to the children of Israel to drink. And he said to Aaron, What has this people done to thee, that thou shouldst bring upon them a most heinous sin? And he answered him, Let not my Lord be offended, for thou knowest this people, that they are prone to evil. They said to me, Make us gods, that may go before us, for as to this Moses, who brought us forth out of the land of Egypt, we know not what is befallen him. And I said to them, Which of you hath any gold? And they took and brought it to me, and I cast it into the fire, and this calf came out. And when Moses saw that the people were naked, for Aaron had stripped them by occasion of the shame of the filth, and had set them naked among their enemies. Naked, having lost not only their gold, and their honor, but what was worst of all, being stripped also of the grace of God, and having lost him. The shame of the filth, that is, of the idol, which they had taken for their God. It is the usual phrase of the Scripture to call idols filth and abominations. Then standing in the gate of the camp, he said, If any man be on the Lord's side, let him join with me. And all the sons of Levi gathered themselves together unto him, and he said to them, Thus saith the Lord God of Israel, Put every man his sword upon his thigh, go, and return from gate to gate through the midst of the camp, and let every man kill his brother, and friend, and neighbor. And the sons of Levi did according to the words of Moses, and there were slain that day about 23,000 men. And Moses said, You have consecrated your hands this day to the Lord, every man in his son and in his brother, that a blessing may be given to you. And when the next day was come, Moses spoke to the people, You have sinned a very great sin, I will go up to the Lord, if by any means I may be able to entreat him for your crime. And returning to the Lord, he said, I beseech thee, this people hath sinned a heinous sin, and they have made to themselves gods of gold, either forgive them this trespass, or if thou do not, strike me out of the book that thou hast written. And the Lord answered him, He that hath sinned against me, him will I strike out of my book, but go thou, and lead this people whither I have told thee, my angel shall go before thee. And I in the day of revenge will visit this sin also of theirs. The Lord therefore struck the people for the guilt on occasion of the calf which Aaron had made. The people mourn for their sin. Moses pitcheth the tabernacle without the camp. He converseth familiarly with God. desireth to see his glory. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, God, get thee up from this place, thou and thy people which thou hast brought out of the land of Egypt, into the land concerning which I swore to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, saying, to thy seed I will give it. And I will send an angel before thee, that I may cast out the Canaanite, and the Amorite, and the Hethite, and the Perizzite, and the Hivite, and the Jebusite, that thou mayst enter into the land that floweth with milk and honey. For I will not go up with thee, because thou art a stiff-necked people, lest I destroy thee in the way. And the people hearing these very bad tidings, mourned, and no man put on his ornaments according to custom. And the Lord said to Moses, say to the children of Israel, thou art a stiff-necked people, once I shall come up in the midst of thee, and shall destroy thee. Now presently lay aside thy ornaments, that I may know what to do with thee. So the children of Israel laid aside their ornaments by Mount Horeb. Moses also taking the tabernacle, pitched it without the camp afar off, and called the name thereof, the Tabernacle of the Covenant. And all the people that had any question, went forth to the Tabernacle of the Covenant, without the camp. And when Moses went forth to the tabernacle, all the people rose up, and every one stood in the door of his pavilion, and they beheld the back of Moses, till he went into the tabernacle. And when he was gone into the Tabernacle of the Covenant, the pillar of the cloud came down, and stood at the door, and he spoke with Moses. And all saw that the pillar of the cloud stood at the door of the tabernacle. And they stood, and worshipped at the doors of their tents. And the Lord spoke to Moses face to face, as a man is wont to speak to his friend. And when he returned into the camp, his servant Joshua the son of Nun, a young man, departed not from the tabernacle. And Moses said to the Lord, thou commandest me to lead forth this people, and thou dost not let me know whom thou wilt send with me, especially whereas thou hast said I know thee by name, and thou hast found favor in my sight. If therefore I have found favor in thy sight, show me thy face, that I may know thee, and may find grace before thy eyes, look upon thy people this nation. And the Lord said, my face shall go before thee, and I will give thee rest. And Moses said, if thou thyself dost not go before, bring us not out of this place. Face to face, that is, in a most familiar manner. Though as we learn from this very chapter, Moses could not see the face of the Lord. I know thee by name, in the language of the Scriptures, God is said to know such as he approves and loves, and to know by name, those whom he favors in a most singular manner, as he did his servant Moses. For how shall we be able to know, I and thy people, that we have found grace in thy sight, unless thou walk with us, that we may be glorified by all people that dwell upon the earth? And the Lord said to Moses, this word also, which thou hast spoken, will I do, for thou hast found grace before me, and thee I have known by name. And he said, show me thy glory. He answered, I will show thee all good, and I will proclaim in the name of the Lord before thee, and I will have mercy on whom I will, and I will be merciful to whom it shall please me. And again he said, thou canst not see my face, for man shall not see me and live. And again he said, behold, there is a place with me, and thou shalt stand upon the rock. And when my glory shall pass, I will set thee in a hole of the rock, and protect thee with my right hand, till I pass, and I will take away my hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face thou canst not see. See my back parts, the Lord by his angel, usually spoke to Moses in the pillar of the cloud, so that he could not see the glory of him that spoke familiarly with him. In the vision here mentioned he was allowed to see something of him, in an assumed corporeal form, not in the face, the rays of which were too bright for mortal eye to bear, but to view him as it were behind, when his face was turned from him. The tables are renewed, all society with the Canaanites is forbid, some precepts concerning the firstborn, the Sabbath, and other feasts. After 40 days fast, Moses returned to the people with the commandments, and his face appearing horned with rays of light, he covereth it, whensoever he speaketh to the people. And after this he said, hew thee two tables of stone like unto the former, and I will write upon them the words which were and the tables, which thou brokest. Be ready in the morning, that thou mayst forthwith go up into Mount Sinai, and thou shalt stand with me upon the top of the mount. Let no man go up with thee, and let not any man be seen throughout all the mount, neither let the oxen nor the sheep feed over against it. Then he cut out two tables of stone, such as had been before, and rising very early he went up into the Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, carrying with him the tables. And when the Lord was come down in a cloud, Moses stood with him, calling upon the name of the Lord. And when he passed before him, he said, O the Lord God, merciful and gracious, patient and of much compassion, and true, who keepest mercy unto thousands, who takest away iniquity, and wickedness, and sin, and no man of himself is innocent before thee, who renderest the iniquity of the fathers to the children, and to the grandchildren, unto the third and fourth generation. And Moses, making haste, bowed down prostrate unto the earth, and adoring, said, If I have found grace in thy sight, O Lord, I beseech thee, that thou wilt go with us, for it is a stiff-necked people, and take away our iniquities and sin, and possess us. The Lord answered, I will make a covenant in the sight of all. I will do signs such as were never seen upon the earth, nor in any nation, that this people, in the midst of whom thou art, may see the terrible work of the Lord which I will do. Observe all things which this day I command thee. I myself will drive out before thy face the Amorite, and the Canaanite, and the Hethite, and the Pherezite, and the Hevite, and the Jebusite. Beware thou never join in friendship with the inhabitants of that land, which may be thy ruin, but destroy their altars, break their statues, and cut down their groves. Adore not any strange god. The Lord his name is jealous, he is a jealous God. Make no covenant with the men of those countries lest, when they have committed fornication with their gods, and have adored their idols, someone call thee to eat of the things sacrificed. Neither shalt thou take of their daughters a wife for thy son, lest after they themselves have committed fornication, they make thy sons also to commit fornication with their gods. Thou shalt not make to thyself any molten gods. Thou shalt keep the feast of the unleavened bread. 7 days shalt thou eat unleavened bread, as I commanded thee in the time of the month of the new corn, for in the month of the springtime thou camest out from Egypt. All of the male kind, that openeth the womb, shall be mine. Of all beasts, both of oxen and of sheep, it shall be mine. The firstling of an ass thou shalt redeem with a sheep, but if thou wilt not give a price for it, it shall be slain. The firstborn of thy sons thou shalt redeem, neither shalt thou appear before me empty. 6 days shalt thou work, the seventh day thou shalt cease to plough, and to reap. Thou shalt keep the feast of weeks with the firstfruits of the corn of thy wheat harvest, and the feast when the time of the year returneth that all things are laid in. 3 times in a year all thy males shall appear in the sight of the Almighty Lord the God of Israel. For when I shall have taken away the nations from thy face, and shall have enlarged thy borders, no man shall lie in wait against thy land when thou shalt go up, and appear in the sight of the Lord thy God thrice in a year. Thou shalt not offer the blood of my sacrifice upon leaven, neither shall there remain in the morning anything of the victim of the solemnity of the Lord. The first of the fruits of thy ground thou shalt offer in the house of the Lord thy God. Thou shalt not boil a kid in the milk of his dam. And the Lord said to Moses, Write these words by which I have made a covenant both with thee and with Israel. And he was there with the Lord 40 days and 40 nights, he neither ate bread nor drank water, and he wrote upon the tables the 10 words of the covenant. And when Moses came down from the Mount Sinai, he held the 2 tables of the testimony, and he knew not that his face was horned from the conversation of the Lord. And Aaron and the children of Israel, seeing the face of Moses horned, were afraid to come near. Horned, that is, shining, and sending forth rays of light like horns. And being called by him, they returned, both Aaron and the rulers of the congregation. And after that he spoke to them. And all the children of Israel came to him, and he gave them in commandment all that he had heard of the Lord in Mount Sinai. And having done speaking, he put a veil upon his face. But when he went into the Lord, and spoke with him, he took it away until he came forth, and then he spoke to the children of Israel all things that had been commanded him. And they saw that the face of Moses when he came out was horned, but he covered his face again, if at any time he spoke to them. The Sabbath. Offerings from making the tabernacle. Basleel and Oholiab are called to the work. And all the multitude of the children of Israel being gathered together, he said to them, "These are the things which the Lord hath commanded to be done. 6 days you shall do work, the seventh day shall be holy unto you, the Sabbath, and the rest of the Lord. He that shall do any work on it, shall be put to death. You shall kindle no fire in any of your habitations on the Sabbath day." And Moses said to all the assembly of the children of Israel, "This is the word the Lord hath commanded, saying, Set aside with you first fruits to the Lord. Let every one that is willing and hath a ready heart, offer them to the Lord, gold, and silver, and brass, violet and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine linen, goat's hair, and ram skins dyed red, and violet colored skins, sedum wood, and oil to maintain lights, and to make ointment, and most sweet incense, onyx stones, and precious stones, for the adorning of the ephod and the rational. Whosoever of you is wise, let him come, and make that which the Lord hath commanded. To wit, the tabernacle and the roof thereof, and the cover, the rings, and the board work with the oars, the pillars, and the sockets, the ark and the staves, the propitiatory, and the veil that is drawn before it, the table with the bars and the vessels, and the loaves of proposition, the candlestick to bear up the lights, the vessels thereof and the lamps, and the oil for the nourishing of fires, the altar of incense, and the bars, and the oil of unction and the incense of spices, the hanging at the door of the tabernacle, the altar of holocaust, and its grate of brass, with the bars and vessels thereof, the laver and its foot, the curtains of the court with the pillars and the sockets, the hanging in the doors of the entry, the pins of the tabernacle and of the court with their little cords, the vestments that are to be used in the ministry of the sanctuary, the vesture of Aaron the high priest, and of his sons, to do the office of priesthood to me." And all the multitude of the children of Israel going out from the presence of Moses, offered first fruits to the Lord with a most ready and devout mind, to make the work of the tabernacle of the testimony. Whatsoever was necessary to the service, and to the holy vestments, both men and women gave bracelets and earrings, rings and tablets. Every vessel of gold was set aside to be offered to the Lord. If any man had violet, and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, fine linen and goat's hair, ram skins dyed red, and violet colored skins, metal of silver and brass, they offered it to the Lord, and sedum wood for divers uses. The skillful women also gave such things as they had spun, violet, purple, and scarlet, and fine linen, and goat's hair, giving all of their own accord. But the princes offered onyx stone, and precious stones, for the ephod and the rational, and spices and oil for the lights, and for the preparing of ointment, and to make the incense of most sweet savor. All both men and women with devout mind offered gifts, that the works might be done which the Lord had commanded by the hand of Moses. All the children of Israel dedicated voluntary offerings to the Lord. And Moses said to the children of Israel, "Behold, the Lord hath called by name Basleel the son of Uri the son of Hur of the tribe of Judah, and hath filled him with the Spirit of God, with wisdom and understanding and knowledge and all learning, to devise and to work in gold and silver and brass, and in engraving stones, and in carpenter's work. Whatsoever can be devised artificially, he hath given in his heart. Oholiab also the son of Achizamak of the tribe of Dan, both of them hath he instructed with wisdom, to do carpenter's work and tapestry, and embroidery in blue and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine linen, and to weave all things, and to invent all new things. The offerings are delivered to the workman, the curtains, coverings, boards, bars, veil, pillars, and hanging are made. Basleel, therefore, and Oholiab, and every wise man, to whom the Lord gave wisdom and understanding, to know how to work artificially, made the things that are necessary for the uses of the sanctuary, and which the Lord commanded. And when Moses had called them, and every skillful man, to whom the Lord had given wisdom, and such as of their own accord had offered themselves to the making of the work, he delivered all the offerings of the children of Israel unto them. And while they were earnest about the work, the people daily in the morning offered their vows. Whereupon the workman, being constrained to come, said to Moses, "The people offereth more than is necessary." Moses therefore commanded proclamation to be made by the crier's voice, "Let neither man nor woman offer any more for the work of the sanctuary." And so they ceased from offering gifts, because the things that were offered did suffice, and were too much. And all the men that were wise of heart, to accomplish the work of the tabernacle, made 10 curtains of twisted fine linen, and violet, and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, with varied work, and the art of embroidering. The length of one curtain was 28 cubits, and the breadth 4, all the curtains were of the same size. And he joined 5 curtains, one to another, and the other 5 he coupled one to another. He made also loops of violet in the edge of the curtain on both sides, and in the edge of the other curtain in like manner, that the loops might meet on against another, and might be joined each with the other. Whereupon also he cast 50 rings of gold, that might catch the loops of the curtains, and they might be made one tabernacle. He made also 11 curtains of goat's hair, to cover the roof of the tabernacle. One curtain was 30 cubits long and 4 cubits broad, all the curtains were of one measure. 5 of which he joined apart, and the other 6 apart. And he made 50 loops in the edge of one curtain, and 50 in the edge of another curtain, that they might be joined one to another. And 50 buckles of brass wherewith the roof might be knit together, that of all the curtains there might be made one covering. He made also a cover for the tabernacle of ram skins dyed red, and another cover over that of violet skins. He made also the boards of the tabernacle of sedum wood standing. The length of one board was 10 cubits, and the breadth was 1 cubit and a half. There were 2 mortises throughout every board, that one might be joined to the other. And in this manner he made for all the boards of the tabernacle. Of which 20 were at the south side southward, with 40 sockets of silver. 2 sockets were put under one board on the 2 sides of the corners, where the mortises of the sides end in the corners. At that side also of the tabernacle, that looketh toward the north, he made 20 boards. With 40 sockets of silver, 2 sockets for every board. But against the west, to wit, at that side of the tabernacle, which looketh to the sea, he made 6 boards, and 2 others at each corner of the tabernacle behind, which were also joined from beneath unto the top, and went together into one joint. Thus he did on both sides at the corners, so there were in all 8 boards, and they had 16 sockets of silver, to wit, 2 sockets under every board. He made also bars of setim wood, 5 to hold together the boards of one side of the tabernacle, and 5 others to join together the boards of the other side, and besides these, 5 other bars at the west side of the tabernacle towards the sea. He made also another bar, that might come by the midst of the boards from corner to corner. And the board works themselves he overlaid with gold, casting for them sockets of silver. And their rings he made of gold, through which the bars might be drawn, and he covered the bars themselves with plates of gold. He made also a veil of violet, and purple, scarlet, and fine twisted linen, varied and distinguished with embroidery. And 4 pillars of setim wood, which with their heads be overlaid with gold, casting for them sockets of silver. He made also a hanging in the entry of the tabernacle of violet, purple, scarlet, and fine twisted linen, with the work of an embroiderer. And 5 pillars with their heads, which he covered with gold, and their sockets he cast of brass. Besleel maketh the ark, the propitiatory, and cherubims, the table, the candlestick, the lamps, and the altar of incense, and compoundeth the incense. And Besleel made also the ark of setim wood, it was 2 cubits and a half in length, and 1 cubit and a half in breadth, and the height was of 1 cubit and a half, and he overlaid it with the purest gold within and without. And he made to it a crown of gold round about, casting 4 rings of gold at the 4 corners thereof, 2 rings in one side, and 2 in the other. And he made bars of setim wood, which he overlaid with gold, and he put them into the rings that were at the sides of the ark to carry it. He made also the propitiatory, that is, the oracle, of the purest gold, 2 cubits and a half in length, and 1 cubit and a half in breadth. 2 cherubims also of beaten gold, which he set on the 2 sides of the propitiatory, one cherub in the top of one side, and the other cherub in the top of the other side, two cherubims at the two ends of the propitiatory, spreading their wings, and covering the propitiatory, and looking one towards the other, and towards it. He made also the table of sedum wood, in length 2 cubits, and in breadth 1 cubit, and in height it was 1.5 cubits. And he overlaid it with the finest gold, and he made to it a golden ledge round about. And to the ledge itself he made a polished crown of gold, of 4 fingers' breadth, and upon the same another golden crown. And he cast 4 rings of gold, which he put in the 4 corners at each foot of the table, over against the crown, and he put the bars into them, that the table might be carried. And the bars also themselves he made of sedum wood, and overlaid them with gold. And the vessels for the divers uses of the table, dishes, bowls, and cups, and censers of pure gold, wherein the libations are to be offered. He made also the candlestick of beaten work of the finest gold. From the shaft whereof its branches, its cups, and bowls, and lilies came out, 6 on the 2 sides, 3 branches on 1 side, and 3 on the other. 3 cups in manner of a nut on each branch, and bowls withal and lilies, and 3 cups of the fashion of a nut in another branch, and bowls withal and lilies. The work of the 6 branches that went out from the shaft of the candlestick was equal. And in the shaft itself were 4 cups after the manner of a nut, and bowls withal at every one, and lilies. And bowls under 2 branches in 3 places, which together make 6 branches going out from 1 shaft. So both the bowls, and the branches were of the same, all beaten work of the purest gold. He made also the 7 lamps with their snuffers, and the vessels where the snuffings were to be put out, of the purest gold. The candlestick with all the vessels thereof weighed 1 talent of gold. He made also the altar of incense of sedum wood, being 1 cubit on every side 4 square, and in height 2 cubits, from the corners of which went out horns. And he overlaid it with the purest gold, with its grate and the sides, and the horns. And he made to it 1 crown of gold round about, and 2 golden rings under the crown at each side, that the bars might be put into them, and the altar be carried. And the bars themselves he made also of sedum wood, and overlaid them with plates of gold. He compounded also the oil for the ointment of sanctification, and incense of the purest spices, according to the work of a perfumer. He maketh the altar of holocaust, the brazen laver, the court with its pillars and hangings, the sum of what the people offered. He made also the altar of holocaust of sedum wood, 5 cubits square, and 3 in height, the horns whereof went out from the corners, and he overlaid it with plates of brass. And for the uses thereof, he prepared divers vessels of brass, cauldrons, tongs, flesh hooks, pot hooks, and fire pans. And he made the grate thereof of brass, in manner of a net, and under it in the midst of the altar a hearth, casting 4 rings at the 4 ends of the net at the top, to put in bars to carry it. And he made the bars of sedum wood, and overlaid them with plates of brass, and he drew them through the rings that stood out in the sides of the altar. And the altar itself was not solid, but hollow, of boards, and empty within. He made also the laver of brass, with the foot thereof, of the mirrors of the women that watch at the door of the tabernacle. He made also the court, in the south side whereof were hangings of fine twisted linen, of 100 cubits, 20 pillars of brass with their sockets, the heads of the pillars, and the whole graving of the work, of silver. In like manner at the north side the hangings, the pillars, and the sockets and heads of the pillars were of the same measure, and work and metal. But on that side that looketh to the west, there were hangings of 50 cubits, 10 pillars of brass with their sockets, and the heads of the pillars, and all the graving of the work, of silver. Moreover towards the east he prepared hangings of 50 cubits, 15 cubits of which were on one side with 3 pillars, and their sockets, and on the other side, for between the two he made the entry of the tabernacle, there were hangings equally of 15 cubits, and 3 pillars, and as many sockets. All the hangings of the court were woven with twisted linen. The sockets of the pillars were of brass, and their heads with all their gravings of silver, and he overlaid the pillars of the court also with silver. And he made in the entry thereof an embroidered hanging of violet, purple, scarlet, and fine twisted linen, that was 20 cubits long, and 5 cubits high according to the measure of all the hangings of the court. and the pillars in the entry were four with sockets of brass, and their heads engravings of silver. The pins also of the tabernacle and of the court round about he made of brass. These are the instruments of the tabernacle of the testimony, which were counted according to the commandment of Moses, in the ceremonies of the Levites, by the hand of Thamar son of Aaron the priest, which Besaleel the son of Uri the son of Hur of the tribe of Judah had made as the Lord commanded by Moses, having for his companion Oholiab the son of Achizamak of the tribe of Dan, who also was an excellent artificer in wood, and worker in tapestry and embroidery in violet, purple, scarlet, and fine linen. All the gold that was spent in the work of the sanctuary, and that was offered in gifts was 29 talents, and 730 sickles according to the standard of the sanctuary. And it was offered by them that went to be numbered, from 20 years old and upwards, of 603,550 men able to bear arms. There were moreover 100 talents of silver, whereof were cast the sockets of the sanctuary, and of the entry where the veil hangeth. 100 sockets were made of 100 talents, 1 talent being reckoned for every socket. And of the 1,775 he made the heads of the pillars, which also he overlaid with silver. And there were offered of brass also 72,000 talents, and 400 sickles besides. Of which were cast the sockets in the entry of the tabernacle of the testimony, and the altar of brass with the grate thereof, and all the vessels that belonged to the use thereof. And the sockets of the court as well round about as in the entry thereof, and the pins of the tabernacle and of the court round about. All the ornaments of Aaron and his sons are made. And the whole work of the tabernacle is finished. And he made, of violet and purple, scarlet and fine linen, the vestments for Aaron to wear when he ministered in the holy places, as the Lord commanded Moses. So he made an ephod of gold, violet, and purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine twisted linen, with embroidered work, and he cut thin plates of gold, and drew them small into threads, that they might be twisted with the woof of the aforesaid colors, and 2 borders coupled one to the other in the top on either side, and a girdle of the same colors, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He prepared also 2 onyx stones, fast set and closed in gold, engraven by the art of a lapidary, with the names of the children of Israel, and he set them in the sides of the ephod for a memorial of the children of Israel, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He made also a rational with embroidered work, according to the work of the ephod, of gold, violet, purple, and scarlet twice dyed, and fine twisted linen, 4 square, double, of the measure of a span. And he set 4 rows of precious stones in it. In the 1st row was a sardius, a topaz, and emerald. In the 2nd, a carbuncle, a sapphire, and a jasper. In the 3rd, a ligurius, an agate, and an amethyst. In the 4th, a chrysolite, an onyx, and a beryl, set and enclosed in gold by their rows. And the 12 stones were engraved with the names of the 12 tribes of Israel, each one with the several name. They made also in the rational little chains linked one to another of the purest gold. And 2 hooks, and as many rings of gold. And they set the rings on either side of the rational, on which rings the 2 golden chains should hang, which they put into the hooks that stood out in the corners of the ephod. These both before and behind so answered one another, that the ephod and the rational were bound together, being fastened to the girdle and strongly coupled with rings, which a violet fillet joined, lest they should flag loose, and be moved one from the other, as the Lord commanded Moses. They made also the tunic of the ephod all of violet, and a hole for the head in the upper part at the middle, and a woven border round about the hole, and beneath at the feet pomegranates of violet, purple, scarlet, and fine twisted linen, and little bells of the purest gold, which they put between the pomegranates at the bottom of the tunic round about, to wit, a bell of gold, and a pomegranate, wherewith the high priest went adorned, when he discharged his ministry, as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made also fine linen tunics with woven work for Aaron and his sons. And mitres with their little crowns of fine linen, and linen breeches of fine linen, and a girdle of fine twisted linen, violet, purple, and scarlet twice dyed, of embroidery work, as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made also the plate of sacred veneration of the purest gold, and they wrote on it with the engraving of a lapidary, the Holy of the Lord, and they fastened it to the mitre with a violet fillet, as the Lord had commanded Moses. So all the work of the tabernacle and of the roof of the testimony was finished, and the children of Israel did all things which the Lord had commanded Moses. And they offered the tabernacle and the roof and the whole furniture, the rings, the boards, the bars, the pillars, and their sockets, the cover of ram skins dyed red, and the other cover of violet skins, the veil, the ark, the bars, the propitiatory, the table, with the vessels thereof, and the loaves of proposition, the candlestick, the lamps, and the furniture of them with the oil, the altar of gold, and the ointment, and the incense of spices, and the hanging in the entry of the tabernacle, the altar of brass, the grate, the bars, and all the vessels thereof, the laver with the foot thereof, the hangings of the court, and the pillars with their sockets, the hanging in the entry of the court, and the little cords, and the pins thereof. Nothing was wanting of the vessels that were commanded to be made for the ministry of the tabernacle, and for the roof of the covenant. The vestments also, which the priests, to wit, Aaron and his sons, used in the sanctuary, the children of Israel offered as the Lord had commanded. And when Moses saw all things finished, he blessed them. The tabernacle is commanded to be set up and anointed. God filleth it with his majesty. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "The first month, the first day of the month, thou shalt set up the tabernacle of the testimony, and shalt put the ark in it, and shalt let down the veil before it, and thou shalt bring in the table, and set upon it the things that are commanded according to the rite. The candlestick shall stand with its lamps, and the altar of gold whereon the incense is burned, before the ark of the testimony. Thou shalt put the hanging in the entry of the tabernacle, and before it the altar of holocaust, the laver between the altar and the tabernacle, and thou shalt fill it with water. And thou shalt encompass the court with hangings, and the entry thereof. And thou shalt take the oil of unction and anoint the tabernacle with its vessels, that they may be sanctified, the altar of holocaust and all its vessels. The laver with its foot, thou shalt consecrate all with the oil of unction, that they may be most holy. And thou shalt bring Aaron and his sons to the door of the tabernacle of the testimony, and having washed them with water, thou shalt put on them the holy vestments, that they may minister to me, and that the unction of them may prosper to an everlasting priesthood." And Moses did all that the Lord had commanded. So in the first month of the second year, the first day of the month, the tabernacle was set up, and Moses reared it up, and placed the boards and the sockets and the bars, and set up the pillars, and spread the roof over the tabernacle, putting over it a cover, as the Lord had commanded. And he put the testimony in the ark, thrusting bars underneath, and the oracle above. And when he had brought the ark into the tabernacle, he drew the veil before it to fulfill the commandment of the Lord. And he set the table in the tabernacle of the testimony at the north side without the veil, setting there in order the loaves of proposition, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He set the candlestick also in the tabernacle of the testimony over against the table on the south side, placing the lamps in order, according to the precept of the Lord. He set also the altar of gold under the roof of the testimony over against the veil, and burnt upon it the incense of spices, as the Lord had commanded Moses. And he put also the hanging in the entry of the tabernacle of the testimony, and the altar of holocaust of the entry of the testimony, offering the holocaust, and the sacrifices upon it, as the Lord had commanded. And he set the laver between the tabernacle of the testimony and the altar, filling it with water. And Moses and Aaron, and his sons washed their hands and feet, when they went into the tabernacle of the covenant, and went to the altar, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He set up also the court round about the tabernacle and the altar, drawing the hanging in the entry thereof. After all things were perfected, the cloud covered the tabernacle of the testimony, and the glory of the Lord filled it. Neither could Moses go into the tabernacle of the covenant, the cloud covering all things and the majesty of the Lord shining, for the cloud had covered all. If at any time the cloud removed from the tabernacle, the children of Israel went forward by their troops; if it hung over, they remained in the same place. For the cloud of the Lord hung over the tabernacle by day, and a fire by night, in the sight of all the children of Israel throughout all their mansions.
Thank you.